And there's fun to be had with it, but its divisive design and departure from the formula, well, it missed the mark. Failing to hit the mark can mean a lot of things, but with FPS games, it usually means it wasn't quite as good as we were expecting or we are disappointed. And to kick off today's list of FPS games, well, they failed to hit any mark, is Fallout 76 Nuclear Winter. What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Drop a like if you guys have an FPS that you were excited for and then it failed you. Does anybody remember Fallout 76 Nuclear Winter? It was kind of a meme in the gaming community a while back to add a battle royale mode to everything, but Fallout 76, well, they pulled it off. They did. Nuclear Winter was added to Fallout 76 on June 10th of 2019. It was a pretty solid battle royale game. Sure, it had some problems, but to be fair, so did everything else in Fallout 76. And all things considered, it was a good addition, but it still had noticeable problems like expected bugs, janky animations, awkward gunfights, gun balance problems. Actually, it had a lot of problems. Unfortunately, the game just wasn't quite good enough to stand on its own 2 feet. And since it was still attached to Fallout 76, which is a game that most people don't care about, it did not take long for Nuclear Winter to fade out of most people's memory. So you guys tell me, are you still playing Nuclear Winter? Did you ever play Nuclear Winter? And most importantly, do you think it would be popular if it was released on its own? I see a lot of you watching the Chaos Gaming content, but you're not subscribed. Take a second, hit that sub button, ring that bell, turn on the notifications, and let's get the Chaos Gaming subscriber number over 30%. Next up is Metroid Prime 3 Corruption. Now, Metroid Prime is one of the greatest games Nintendo has ever made, and if you disagree with that, well, we're probably going to have a problem in the comment section. The sequel, Prime 2, well, it was good. It added upon the structure of the first in a natural way. Many people even consider it to be better than the first, but I've yet to see a single person say Prime 3 is the best in the trilogy, and it's not hard to see why. Metroid Prime 3 was released for the Wii, that's right, the Wii, in 2007. Had several delays, added a few new gameplay mechanics to the mix like flying Samus's gunship and alterations to the control scheme to fit the Wiimote and Nunchuck. Thank God we don't have to say those anymore. Metroid Prime 3 was a really good game and certainly one of the upper tier Wii exclusives, but when compared to the other two in the series, it's hard not to think that it was a bit of a step back, a bit of a digression, if you will. The numbers, they don't like it. Metroid Prime 3 currently sits with the lowest critic and user scores on Metacritic, although they're still decent scores. At number 8, Call of Duty Ghosts. Now, Ghosts, it was in a weird place. Now we're used to every few years getting an experimental Call of Duty game that shakes up the formula and tries to draw people back in. Most recently, it was Black Ops 4. Before that, it was Advanced Warfare. But the first experimental COD game was actually Call of Duty Ghosts back in 2013, and whether or not it succeeded really depends on who you ask, which is why it gets a spot on the list today. Ghost kept the established formula from the Modern Warfare trilogy, but it added new elements like field orders, a more team-based approach, less emphasis on killstreaks, and a weird character system with squad points instead of a traditional single character progression. Now, Ghost got pretty mixed reception from the COD community, with some calling it a great new take on the Modern Warfare formula, while others, they downright hated it. It was too slow, too campy, and too different. But today, there's actually a lot of people who still play this game, but there are also people who still hate it. So it kind of felt right to put it on the list because regardless of what you think of Ghost, I think it's safe to say that it missed the mark for a lot of people. Next up is Rage 2. Raise your hand if you remember this game. Rage 2 was hyped. Yes, it was, leading up to the release, but then it fell flat on its face rapidly. This open-world FPS was meant to be a follow-up to the 2010 game Rage, which was praised for its gunplay, its visuals, but it was criticized for being grindy and repetitive. Earlier this year, yeah, this wasn't very long ago, along came Rage 2, which was praised for its gameplay and visuals, but you guessed it, criticized for everything else, including grindy, repetitive gameplay. Now, yeah, some would say it was an improvement over the original, but it didn't exactly stick with gamers very long, and it fell out of the public eye rather quickly. Now, there's still fun to be had with the game, and maybe it just needed some more time in the oven to fine-tune the open-world design. I don't know, but why is it every game is trying to be open-world now? At number 6, and I hate putting any Halo game on a negative-type list, but I have to. I have to be honest here. Halo 5, super weird case. As you probably know, Halo 4 was a pretty dramatic departure from the established Halo formula, and it was super divisive in the community with player counts drying up. Now, when it came to the sequel, 343 Industries had two roads they could take. They could either go back to the traditional Halo gameplay, or they could go even further with the advancements they made with Halo 4. Guess which road they took? Option number two. Halo 5 was another pretty big step away from the classic Halo formula. Why we do that, I don't know. More movement abilities were added, the time to kill was shortened a bit, and the overall gameplay was much faster than any previous Halo title. And I guess that's good and bad. It was good because Halo 5 was generally much more polished than Halo 4, thanks to the fact that 343 was now able to fully realize their vision, but it was bad because it went even further away from what longtime fans wanted from a Halo game. So, I guess Halo 5 missed the mark, because while it was polished, it also was not what people wanted in the Halo community. It didn't take long for a lot of people to actually just walk away from it. So hopefully, fingers crossed, guys, Halo Infinite gets things back on track. At number five, Far Cry New Dawn. Now let me start off by saying, if you liked Far Cry 5, you probably had some good fun with Far Cry New Dawn. But if you were hoping for something a little different or maybe an improvement over Far Cry 5, well, this ain't it, chief, at all. Far Cry New Dawn was marketed as a mini sequel to Far Cry 5, but it was really more of a standalone expansion, featuring most of the same map, weapons, characters, mission structure, animation, so on and so forth. Basically, the developers took the assets of Far Cry 5 and put together a new smaller game that carried on the story of the base game, and they sold it for $40. And that is where, well, what I said before comes in. Fans of Far Cry didn't have much of a problem with New Dawn, since it was basically just more of a game they already liked, but those who were a little bit let down by Far Cry 5 and were hoping for an improvement were left disappointed to the abundance of reused assets and the lack of actual difference in the gameplay. Like most games on this list, there's fun to be had in New Dawn, but with a 3.7 user score on Metacritic, I think it's safe to say New Dawn missed the mark. At number four, Evolve. Man, this game had so much potential. It's a shame that it was handled so poorly on the business side of things. It was an asymmetrical multiplayer shooter from the makers of Left 4 Dead that had one player taking control of a powerful monster, while a few others took control of hunters trying to kill a monster within a certain time limit and get out of the arena alive. Now, the core gameplay of Evolve was pretty well done, and despite the game's poor reputation, there is fun to be had if you have buddies that you can party up with. But what killed the game was the way it was handled on the back side of things. The game launched with a $60 full price tag, despite only having a handful of game modes. Plus, it had a huge season pass. Plus, it had literally hundreds of dollars worth of microtransactions, and developers were far more concerned with adding more paid content rather than fixing the problems of the core game. Does that sound familiar, anybody? Now, this obviously pushed a lot of player base away, and the servers quickly became a ghost town, even after it was forced into a free-to-play model. But could you imagine how differently we would look at Evolve today if it launched for $20 or even $30? Heck, they could have launched this game as a free-to-play game and sold all the season pass content as microtransactions, and that probably still would have been a hit. But no, the publisher was greedy about it. Despite having some really good gameplay ideas, Evolve flopped. At number three, Wolfenstein Youngblood. Another 2019 game to make the list. Launched just a couple weeks ago, actually, well, in July of this year, and it was the fourth installment of the rebooted Wolfenstein series. Rather than being just a linear single-player game, Youngblood was a co-op-focused open world set 20 years after the events of Part 2. Now, the gunplay was good. The visuals were some of the best on the market. That's to be expected. The changes to the gameplay were really diversive amongst gamers. Now, some people liked the less linear approach to the story, but others hated it much, much more as it took away from the storytelling, which was an element that the new series was good at. It also didn't help things at launch that the game was really buggy and the enemy health and damage balancing was awful. It made the game feel tedious and grindy as opposed to fast-paced and badass like the previous games. Improvements have been made since launch, that's how it always works, and there's fun to be had with it, but its divisive design and departure from the formula, well, it missed the mark. At number two, Counter-Strike Condition Zero. I guess you could say this is one of the original FPS games to miss the mark. It was the second standalone Counter-Strike game to be released, and it came out a full 5 years after the original. Development of CS:GO jumped between a handful of different companies, which isn't a good sign. And the end goal was to make a Counter-Strike game that continued the fun of the original's multiplayer while also adding in some single-player elements like a campaign and offline play with bots. Now, the game launched in 2004 for PC to pretty mediocre reviews from critics due to the subpar AI and the dated visuals, and the Counter-Strike community, they were pissed with the multiplayer. Most CS players ended up just going back to the first game, and Valve panicked due to the low sales of Condition Zero, to the point that they streamlined a remake of the first game titled Counter-Strike Source, which ended up being a fan favorite. So, Condition Zero was a pretty disappointing flop upon release, but going back and looking at it now, it's not the worst game. It currently holds an 88% approval rating on Steam, so clearly there are people who loved it. It just wasn't quite what the core Counter-Strike audience wanted. And at number one, the epitome of missing the mark, Fallout 4. Now, this is a mainline entry. Fallout 4 launched in 2015 was immediately polarizing in the gaming world. Up until this point, Bethesda's Fallout games had earned a reputation for being extremely immersive with great dialogue options, engaging stories, excellent maps, and fun quest design. But a lot of that was seemingly thrown out the window when Bethesda was designing Fallout 4. It was much less of an RPG and much more of an open-world shooting game. Now, many gameplay elements were removed from the mix, and dialogue options were severely toned down. But what really made up for everything was the customization and the mod support, which are what kept the game still heavily being played to this day. But it's hard to deny that many people were really, really let down with Fallout 4 due to how much it walked away from the RPG format and decided to be more about shooting. Those who wanted to shoot things in a post-apocalyptic society definitely got their needs met, but those looking for true RPG elements, well, they were let down. And I give Fallout 4 the number one spot on this list today because it missed the mark. Some of you aren't going to like that, and I get that, but I had to say it. There you go. Those are some games that missed the mark, failed to hit the mark. Whatever you want to say, you let me know one that didn't make the list. There is a video up on the screen right now. I need you guys to hit the mark. Click on that video, and I will see you over there.